topology for the topology. Starting from the definition point of view, a network topology describes the configuration and communication of a network at the physical and logical elements of node. The types of the topology are bus, star, ring, tree, mesh and hybrid topology. So this is the logical diagram of a topological network. So this is the bus topology, this one is tree, this one is ring and this one is star. This is hybrid topology and this picture describes mesh topology. Coming to the next slide, we are dealing with the bus topology. So bus topology is a kind of network topology that each node connected to a middle backbone. So this middle backbone helps to transmit data in a single loop from this point to this point without interference of any other node. If one node want to transmit data from one node to the other node, then these middle nodes will not interfere the transmission. The next benefits of bus topology. It is the cost effective topology and the cable length required is the least comparison to other topologies. The working of this topology is easy to understand. Expansion can be done easily by linking the cables together. Coming to the drawbacks of this topology, if the main cable collapses, the complete network collapses and the network performance at its stake reduces if there are numerous node and heavy network traffic. The main cable can only be so long, the length of the cable is limited. Next, the bus topology is not as fast as the ring topology. Coming to our next topology, it is tree topology. This is the physical diagram of a tree topology where we are finding these are the nodes. These nodes can be described as the hub. This connected with the additional sub-hubs. These sub-hubs provide connection to the different computers and these computers or devices can be connected so as to provide a configuration like tree topology. Tree topology is a kind of topology in which the nodes are connected in a hierarchical manner and this hierarchy may be continue up to tree level. So the tree topology applied in case of wide area network, it is an extension of bus topology and star topology and it is best suited to the workstation model of a network. Next, coming to the benefits of tree topology. Tree topology is easy to expand with one or more nodes and it is easy to maintain or manage because if one node is one configuration of tree is damaged, then it can be corrected and the error detection in the network can be easy. Then drawbacks of tree topology. The drawbacks is only when it is profoundly cabled and it is expensive when compared to other topologies. The root node if collapses, the network will also collapse. Next, coming to our ring topology. Here it is the physical arrangement of a ring. Here it is connected all the computers and other CPU and here we can also connect the printers. These are the devices which connect in the ring topology. Ring, so definition point of view, it is the type of topology in which every computer is connected to another computer. Here one computer is connected to another computer, so one computer connected with two computers in the adjacent sites. So when the data transmission occur start from first node, it will transfer to every node and finally reach the destination. If the destination is this point, then it transfers from this node and continuously transmit data through this. So this will form a ring transmission of data. Next, coming to the benefits of ring topology. So what affects the ring topology? Whenever we are connecting the nodes in a heavy traffic, the nodes passing token cannot lose the data. And ring topology has cheap installation and expansion. It needs a less cabling. Then drawbacks of ring topology. it is a tedious task to troubleshoot in a ring topology, as all the computers connected in a ring. So if one node is damaged, then the error detection will be difficult, and every computer in that ring crashes. Next, coming to star topology. Star topology, here this is the physical arrangement of a star network. Taking the example of our college network, if this is the middle hub and all these are the connecting nodes, like these are the departments, these are the administration buildings, these are the nodes. So main hub is connected with the adjacent nodes. And the definition, coming to the definition, star topology is a kind of network topology in which all the nodes are connected by a cable to a single node. These are the nodes connected with the single node. So hub must be activated while the connection required to activate. So hub is the main part of a star topology. And it is mainly known as the passive connection or passive intelligent nodes. Next, the benefits of star topology. So star topology is the fast performing network topology in a low network traffic. Whenever the hub is at first speed, then the star topology may provide the higher rate of transmission of data. So drawbacks, it can take the hub, it can be described like installation cost is extreme and it is costly to use, and if the hub is damaged, then all the nodes will be disconnected and the transmission will stop. Next, coming to mesh topology. So mesh, according to the name, mesh is this type of configuration occur. When this type of configuration occur in a network, then this is known as the mesh topology. So in here, mesh is the topology configuration done by connecting one node of computer to each and every node of computer, each and every node in that network. So mesh is the kind of topology in which all the nodes are connected with other nodes. So the connection, we can calculate one node can connected with the n into n minus 1 channels in that particular network. Next, the benefits of mesh topology. So every connection in, has the ability to carry the data. This is the benefit. And it is very robust, it is maintained, it is easy to maintain and diagnose to fault tolerance is very good. Mesh topology provides privacy and security. Next, the drawback of mesh topology. Mesh topology is challenging to install and configure, as all the nodes are connected with each and other nodes. So it is very challenging that the cabling must be done right, otherwise the connection must be failed. Next, coming to hybrid topology. This is the last one. The hybrid topology, as you can see this in this diagram, hybrid means configuring all the topologies in one single LAN connection. So here is the bus topology, here is the tree topology, here is the ring topology. So here, when all the topologies combine, it will form the hybrid topology. Next, coming to the benefits of hybrid topology. So it is very easy to troubleshoot and easy to detect the error. As all the connections are different from each other, so here if one connection get damaged or any error arise, then it can be corrected without hampering these two connections. Then it is very scalable. As scalable means, if you want to install the BOSS network here, then the cost effectiveness of bus is less than that ring, and ring is also cost effective than that of tree. So this also gives us scalable compatibility. Then it is the drawbacks of hybrid topology. It is very complicated to design, as here the involvement of all topologies are there. So it is very complicated to design. The nodes which are connecting to the computers must be connected correctly so as to provide the non-interference data transmission. It is very expensive as it involves more than one topologies. So concluding our topic, we have various network topologies available to us along with their drawbacks and benefits.